This is not a story about the Oshun River, but in a way, it is. This is not a story about the Oshun Grove, but in a way, it is. This is not a story about the people of Oshogbo, though, in a way, it is. It is a story about Africa, one way or another. It is a story about Nigeria, in a way. It is a story about Oshogbo, somehow. Arguably, it is a story about culture. But best of all, it is about patrimony. When I set out for the Oshun Grove in Oshogbo, I did not know what awaited me. I was warned by most people who professed to be Christians to beware of evil spirits, demons that inhabited the grove. Demons that moved around like the roaring devil seeking whom to devour. Shockingly, most of those Christians never granted me an interview, but a few who did spoke only with me off camera. It hurt me I could not get Christians' perspectives to my story. Although it is recorded in the scriptures that the righteous is as bold as a lion, none of the church leaders and Christians with whom I conversed was willing and bold to face the camera. The World Heritage List was created under the terms of the 1972 Convention Concerning the Protection of the World Cultural and Natural Heritage. It numbers 936 properties, which form part of the world's cultural and natural heritage, considered as outstanding universal values. Two locations in Nigeria appear on this World Heritage List. First is Sokoto, Africa's first World Heritage cultural landscape, located in Adamawa State. Second is the Oshun Grove. The grove also supports the endangered white-throat monkey. Oshun Grove is also a highly sacred sanctuary where shrines, sculptures, and artworks were erected by Suzanne Wenger and a group of local artists called New Sacred Art, in honor of Oshun and other Yoruba deities.
The Oshun Oshogbo Sacred Grove is a UNESCO World Heritage Site listed in July 2005 in Durban, South Africa. It is a primary rainforest that is made up of virtually every cultural and natural preservation, you know, by the Yoruba people more than 600 years ago, specifically Oshogbo people. It is also the foundation of Oshogbo Kingdom. That is where Oshogbo started. That is the beginning of Oshogbo as a city.
In the year 1270 AD, the goddess of the river, who came right from Igede-Ekiti and settled down in Oshogbo within the grove, nobody knew anything about her. It was one day when Obalaroye migrated from Ipuliomu because of scarcity of water and settled within the grove. He never knew that the goddess of the river had established her own kingdom within the grove, being assisted by the lesser spirit within the grove. One day, one of the subjects of Obalaroye was clearing ground for the next planting season. A tree fell into the river, and there was a loud voice saying, "Laroye Olutime, you have destroyed all my dying pots." The two gentlemen were astonished. They never knew how the god of the river knew about their names. So he ordered them, the god of the river told them to move to the upper part of the river.
Obinrin ni won nse orisha omi de ni won won si je alaanu orisha to ye pe ko si nkan te ba lo si be bayi te ba bere ti won ni se elomi o le jowo lo fe to ba so pe osun osogboro ki owo ni mo fe o iwo yi odun to nbo je ki ni ki wa dupe o ko to dodun to nbo won afun elomi le so pe omo lo nfe o osun ko to dodun to nbo je ki gbo moko wa sodo re o.
Now, we had two palaces within the group. The first palace was being established by Oba Laroye, who migrated from Ipuliom and settled down permanently within the group. That was the first palace. But the god of the river advised him and Olutime to move from that place to the upper part, which is now called Iledi Ontutu, because human beings cannot live peaceably with the spirit. Because the first place where they established his palace was being occupied by the spirit and the goddess of the river. They established another palace there and a flourishing market. But they have to move because of the population explosion to move to the present site, which is now being called Oshogbo Oroki Asala.
It is a primary rainforest in the whole of Yoruba nation that is still kept intact, that has not been vandalized. Even though there are challenges, like I said, there are...
Nobody knew anything about the group, how important it is culturally, economically, to the people of Oshogbo. It was when Chusawenja came to Nigeria from elsewhere. He settled down at Ilobu briefly for some time. But when she came to witness the celebration of Oshogbo Festival in the year 1958, during the time of Oba Adenle, the Ataja of Oshogbo, she realized that Oshogbo has a very important cultural heritage, which is yet to be developed. So she came, then she left Ilobu and settled down in Oshogbo here.
She stayed at Ibukun Road, one of the upstairs there. Then she started erecting some structure that will depict our culture. We never knew that we have very rich culture. Since then, people have been coming right from far and wide to the city of Oshogbo to witness the Great of Oshos Festival. They usually go into the group to know what Chusawenja has done to expose our culture.
Ti eto ba doko tin sun ko logba ti oko yo waste aye ara ni e ti ma nlo tin bo tin ko eko yo ma gbon ogbon bo sinu ogbon mama ko eko lara wa awa na ko eko lara won nipa awon orisa won yen oto ni ti mama gan to le pe lo mo odo ti wa na lo ti mama olorisa ni mama en to devote igbesi aye re si orisa ini mo wo isa ya re o fi ara re le fun orisa
awon akanda eyan ni won e wa wansi orisirisi eyan a fe lati lo si odo won lati lo gbe elomi oni koye to ma na so ki le eyan fe ti o si nbe sugbon lati muru won so pe kawon wa si bi bayi kon fi ara won ji to je pe gbogbo nkan san ni ori osun yi na 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 si to ba je lomi ile lo ma so pe ko ma kojo ko po to ba je lomi ani ko ra mo to po sugba won won se yen gbogbo eyan to ba ti ri to ba ti ni elomi ani ara won oya won ani ko wa won a fun lowo pe ko lo gba toju ni ile iwosan so gbogbo owo ton ba fun won fun ebun o kini kan ori osun yen na na le lati ma fi je ko baje
o ti wa nu ese odun fa kakiri to so nipa nkan ba ni to pe eniko ba nkan je eniko to se mama ma bi europe ama mi to gbe se igbala nigeria ni ko se enikan ko ran wa awon osa na won ti de won ti lese de bi to fi wa.
Ocean Grove has become synonymous with late Susan Wenju. Susan and her late husband, Hule Bear, from whom she separated, trained some local artists in different crafts. This local artist, together with Susan, established in the Sacred Grove different reminiscences of Yoruba gods. They also helped to maintain, in the Sacred Grove, Oshogbo history and cultural heritage.
A man she egbe kan sacred art la man pe gogo awa to je ipe aje omo mama o awon kan wa to deje ipe gogo ise un patapata ton je onise ona ayaworan imi man se aso imi man gbe igi awon mi gbe okuta gogo won patapata benya so am pe ara wa ni new sacred art.
Awa ta je awon ta jo wa nbe ngba na la kura ojo won ko ni sacred art emi ni shaman won gba to ba so na si gbugbu osun awon ma pe pana pana ti won ba pa gbohun to je ki won osunna ta ma ja nbe ta ma gba we la ma so osun be ko ba won sunna a ma yan awon kan ni wa we are 14 number ko lowo osu o ko ni kan nu free ni o la je ki be nkan won fi le baje eni won se.
We have various types of art, but when you are gaining something from that type of art, you, some people have produced some years back, I can say that is the meaning of sacred art. If you place a stone on the corner of your room and you are worshipping it, you have at the back of your mind that you want to gain something from that stone. An invisible spirit must have been in that object. It will give you some things. That is what we call sacred art. Look at this.
Àwọn iṣẹ́ tí mo sọ yẹn ti olukaluku se awon kan wa to je pe a nse fun tita awon kan wa ta kin ta rara biru awon kan wa to je pe biru ele awon ti mo so pe ke ma ya ko nse nkan ti eyan kan le ma gbe kakiri nkan to ti wa ni to je pe ko de nse pe boya bi pe ke won fi se photo lati ma fi han gbogbo eyan eh. So iru yen be yen a kin ta iru awon kan be yen.
Most of the sacred art are historic in nature. To my chagrin, I was instructed never to have some of them photographed. Some of those artworks are spirit, never to be exposed. But I made a discovery from the priestess of the grove. When Susan Wenja first came in contact with Oshogbo, she bought, maybe, lots of such works or other artifacts part of the Oshogbo heritage. She sent such works abroad. I wonder if this could be the reason some people speculate that Susan only associated with Oshogbo so as to take some things from them. However, one can never put into disrepute the positive role of Susan in reviving the Oshogbo cultural heritage.
Àwa fa yi gba pe ebo lo mo ese to bayi lo mo ese sa to bayi ebo wa duro ti leyin papa gba to de emi ti e kere ngba to de to kokko de tin le re ka se ra gbogbo nkan tin ko lo tin ko bo lo si bo nko lo lu ebo eh orisi isi gbogbo nkan se n baye awo omo tan fi sara mi won fi sayeye lodo won lo la pin awo omo pe won ko wa leru lo ni ṣùgbọ́n ìgbà tó pẹ́ atẹ́gùn àwọn èèyàn wa náà ojúlà ọ̀làjúdà àwọn èèyàn wa náà ń lọ lókè wọ́n ń bọ̀ wọ́n rí gbogbo ẹ wọn fi nǹkan wa tọrẹ mọ́ tó dàbí ẹ bá gbé bílí ọ̀wá wa náà ta mọ́.
Oh, the way we look at late Madam Susan Wenja is that the woman was an enigma. The National Commission for Museums and Monuments take that woman in high esteem. The opinion of people, like I said, differs on several issues. I will never subscribe to the idea that maybe she stole some things or ideas and artifacts and so on and so forth. It's a type of person we can say that she came, she saw, and she conquered. She intermingled with the society. She separated from the husband and married a local drummer. just to ensure that she had a deep relationship with the society and the commitment. She was even christened, another name for her is Adunio Lorisha. So she became interested in our natural environment, particularly her efforts. I repeat again, her efforts in the Star Sacred Grove culminated or resulted in the declaration as a national monument in 1965 and then as a World Heritage Site in 2005. So she has contributed a lot. Her effort should no longer be seen from that parochial view. Recently, UNESCO, you know, single-handedly said we should compile the reason why this site should be the best example, the best, you know, practice for all other sacred groups all over the world. So talking about the previous, the past colonial masters, people came for different agenda. People came, you know, colonial masters, some came for missionary some activity, some came for economic issues, some came for political conquest. You know, so she has done her part, she has done her best, and she has, you know, actually she sleeps virtually in the groove. She will go with lantern, she will go with torchlight and her dogs. She was fond of carrying and, you know, being accompanied by pets, specifically dogs, to hunt people who may be doing anything that is, you know, that may desecrate the groove even at night. So she spent all her time, you know, more than 50 years of the 92 years she spent to ensure that that place was preserved. And she was satisfied when that place was declared a World Heritage Site in 2005 before her death. She said she was fulfilled.
Ojubosun ati igbo re mama wa adone won ba nibe ni ile wa nbe igbo wa nbe awon gilanla bi igba meji odun won wa nbe to po gan to pe kaakiri agbaye ati ri igbo to tun ri be yen ri awon ibo won wa igbo won wa wo bo se ri ama awon eyan wa ta la ni ini gba ti pe gba re ni aka tawon aye wa fi nkole ngba mo ma adun re do ni kini ki ma se aka igba to mo wulo ti en le jeun ni be marin ti pe ti ma je mi ayo ma so pe hun ibi nki ta fi nje yi oda ju ini igbo osun je mama lo so di gbaju gbaja tawon eyan wa npe wo losun awala ni ama ni ni aka kun nkan ti oda nkan elebo radarada o si buruku ene bo pe la won me se omo na wa de pa fe wa bi bayi ni 1970 kene kan won la mo wa inu wa do pe adupe lowo olohun me se omo ti gba pe ko ni se igba me se omo de dogo wa la wa de won wa ngegi won se gbogbo won gi la won gi an won ni kan won ko bi se mi se won ko bi se ko won ko kene kan o gegi lanu a ko wa me se omo de yan won lojo da awon ni wa ko ba won digital wa awon ni wa so n ba be nje si won tan ba je si na ba ni wo se won le nu da mewa won le se yo kan yoku won nu male ni ba se wa be ti ti do ninu yes ko na ti de be na ko se kan ti won se o ko lati la won ni won se iso lowo awon ka ma da gbogbo nkan ba ni na gbogbo be ti won se hun bi ti won se hun ise joba mi se omo lo se awa la se lan lo bebe ro awon ambassador pupo won won da owo jo pe kan ti mo ti se ko mo di baje won wa ja ma kan wa dawo jo won da jo won o lo kan bi o je bi 6 million naira won ni ka ko ta ko fa won si ohun won ti ko kan fi se fence abi so won pe wo mo ra won lo won pe ni won pe mo ra won lowo to dawo da ni ma fi se ta si le ijoba wa wa lele mi si ohun te won boju to won o se o e wa fe se won pe wo ni won le mu wọ́n lè mú 500,000 báyìí tí fáwọn èèyàn 50,000 bẹ́ẹ̀ ó pé kò mọ́ra wọn lọ́wọ́ ni bẹ́ẹ̀ ṣe ṣe nàìjíríà ni.
People are building, they want to build houses inside this groove before Mama Zusa Wenja took over from people of Osogbo. They want to farm inside this place.
In the 1830s, Osogbo became a refugee town for people fleeing the Fulani Jihad. In the legendary Battle of Osogbo, the Ibadan troops defeated the Fulani army. The people of Oshogbo credit the defeat to the power of Oshun, the water goddess, who turned into a food vendor. Oshun sold the Fulani army poisoned akara, bean cakes, which killed many of the Fulanis. In this way, the Fulani jihad was resisted. In spite of these defeats, today, most inhabitants of Oshogbo are Muslims.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillah. الذي خلق كل شيء فقدره تقديرا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يهاب لمن يشاء إناثا ويهاب لمن يشاء ذكورا ويزوجهم ذكورانا وإناثا ويجعل من يشاء قيما
وقال الله على كل شيء to worship any other thing out of his creature like the stone or worshiping the river or the tree and so many other things that people are worshiping. This is known as shirk. Even in Islam, shirk is divided into two. We have shirk al-akbar or shirk al-asgar. That is the big shirk and the one that is small. The big one is one that is a way of associating other partner with Almighty Allah. Means believing that there is something you know that is it can provide some things for you. Maybe you believe that this thing you are worshiping can provide money for you, can give you child, can provide many other things. And this thing, we need to know that there is nobody that can do this for us than Almighty Allah. So that is the type of things people are doing also. Like people going there to seek for child, to seek for money, promotion, and some other things like that. That one is forbidden in Islam.
Wale ma ro ko lo isani wa o ko na ko ko ira wa esi meta lo wa ni aye igbagbo wa imole wa awo elesa abalaye ni ogo awo elesa abalaye la wa ni dire ta si le ko e ma ta iku ta wo se ta wo iku ni
awon to gba sa lowo wa ni nsin ko se be ibo ni esin eje esin to lagbara gan ti ba se to lagbara o ti ku ani gun re mo Christian owo money won fi da fun kini yen ti o ko exist mo Muslim wa igba ti ogun sisa ta fi ku awa ta ko for us a letter to school won ka lo kun ta ko 1957 won mo mi lo si school kin lo doctor ni won le mi danu won ni ki lo fa run ori mi tabi kin bog ni ko lorun kin lo baptize tabi kin ni Christian bo se ko ka ki owo lodo wa nu. I'm training by myself. Nobody in law school can you? Nitori ese na ni. Ba mi ki ya ma law school kan. Ngba ta tun dodo adun ni ti mo ni fa law school ni ti ba lo ni won mu mi kirun. Ta mo so mi di Muslim. Pe aye mi baje nu. Ya na ti ko nu ye lo.
Yes, you know this issue about the attitude of several Africans towards traditional religion is not really unique to the Nigerian situation. This dates way back to colonialism and evangelization, you know, of the African continent. And one thing that occurred was with both Christianity and Islam, it's not just Christianity, they sort of denigrated our own forms of worship. Now, people say, well, you know, in certain forms of African religion, there is a lot of fetish, this and the other. But my answer to that is this. If you look at any organized form of religion, okay, what is referred to as fetish also exists in the rituals of some of these religions. All right? Now, the word fetish is an ugly word because it connotes evil and it connotes not believing in what the Christian call their own real God, or what the Muslims call their own real God. The fact of the matter is, all societies have a vision or an understanding of who their God is. And what we're seeing in the continent with this heavy dosage of evangelization is that these missionaries have succeeded to a significant extent to let several Africans believe that it is only one way to see God, to understand God, and in essence, to go to heaven. And it is only restricted to certain types of denomination. So you would have people, for example, who believe in the born again concept. They would not even say Catholics can go to heaven, you know, or Lutherans can go to heaven. Because the theology says, unless you are born again, you know, you belong to a Pentecostal church or a charismatic church, you cannot go to heaven. And compounded with that, some of these churches, you know, have started putting less emphasis on salvation, that is going to heaven, and more emphasis on prosperity.
Why Nigerians are so stupid like that? These people wearing hijab and walking here. Say them about bagging. Say one for us. That one you know about the queer. Bagging here. Left here. Or is it alone? Remember 200,000. No shoe leg. 150,000. 100,000. I think banu. You don't come to 4 years ago. Gbogbo awon ti mama gba gan o fa sa gbogbo won o sa gbogbo won ko je to ri se kan be mo nisin but a kike ki won se a se baun awon tin se awon te gba ewun o le mo kan se engineering losun ko fe engineering ise brace opolo ni se te ja janu ini ise triangle four square nkan kan ko ise anjanu ti won ta meditation ini kini leyi mo so da bi meta pada nbe won era awon ko we won todun to ma fin mo je to tu jo ma ko ri le lai se kankan awon ebo ni won ko ra won jo ti won san owo ta fin to be nse lodo odun won ma san owo awon ori o pe a chairman won le mi nbe.
And if you go to the groove now, you see some restoration work that are done by the Adunni Olorisa Trust. After her exit, after her demise, those people came together to fund, you know, a trust fund. You know, they are now used, you know, occasionally as money is available to make some restoration work to ensure that, you know, her legacy are not forgotten.
Anyway, we were employed as a staff here by government, by federal government, under National Commission for Museums and Monuments. And a majority of the people that works with Mama, they are part of us. We have a traditional beginners. They are part of us. And we have a traditional carvers. They are still part of us.
So, are you a Muslim or a Christian?
I'm a Christian.
Conflict exists among indigenous religion, Christianity, and Islam. Without any doubt, traditionalists have become custodians of our cultural heritage. Only two options are available for a people whose culture has either been corrupted or killed. Such people can either become corrupted people or dead people. I therefore inquired from different organizations, schools, and individuals how they have tried to keep Oshogbo cultural heritage alive in spite of various religious challenges.
Then our heart is not only Oshogbo heart. Like my works, I try to blend between the academic and the Oshogbo, both in my painting and in my carving. Because this is modern carving now. I also do traditional carvings, but I try to speak the Yoruba language. You get what I mean? exactly what Yoruba stand for, some of our cultures, some of our culture per se. Marriage, festivals, notable figures, deities. So, Oshogbo has its own uniqueness. That is for life, not for a community, not for a set of people, but basically we try to speak the language of Yoruba in some of our works. You see a lot of paintings in dancing and drumming, some of paintings in the festivals in Yoruba, in Igbo, and sort of, you know, speak African language, speak the unity within the country. Long time ago, I've done a lot of paintings on Osun Festival. The Yoruba, they have the festival with ghosts. Then I even have a carving in there about Osun, the Yoruba, the Kabiyesi, those that were beating themselves, the drama, dancing, jubilation during the festival.
In the first instance, you see the advent, the coming of Christianity and Islamic religion has affected the way people embrace or they want to embrace traditional religion. Ogun, believing in Ogun, believing in Shango, believing in even the Osun river goddess, and so on and so forth. It has affected it a lot. It has, but be that as it may, there are still some, the core people who still believe that this is their, like they used to tell us, this is our own church, in quote, this is our own mosque, and this is our own belief, this is our own, we value this, so they can do anything to protect it as well. The National Commission for Museums and Monuments, what we met on ground, we are preserving, and we are promoting, and we are conserving. There are a lot of, like I said, there are a lot of challenges, but you see, we encourage the annual festival, you know, which is the reenactment of the bond between the river goddess and the Kabiyesi, the Ataoja of Oshogbo. They still believe sincerely that Osun protects Oshogbo land, protect the people. We are doing what, you know, the conservation management plan, the operational guideline for UNESCO has said we should be doing concerning, you know, the status for which the group has been elevated. We also, you know, do celebrate the One Monument Day every year, April 18. We also celebrate International Museum Day, May 18. April 18 is the first one. May 18 is the second one. So you see that we do a lot to, we have brochures, we have researchers still come. And the most important thing is that annually, you see a lot of Yoruba and blacks in diaspora from Cuba, from Brazil, from America, from Europe, coming here, from all over African continent, coming here to pay homage and to even, you have replicas of Osun in all those countries. People are so proud and, you know, but depending, like I said, on individual belief and the value they attach to the group. Our own responsibility is not to force people, it's a voluntary, you know, operation, it's a voluntary situation. So we encourage people, we preserve it as it is, as we want to preserve it forever. And then there is a review of the act that set up our commission going on in the National Assembly. There is no nation that treats his or her heritage with levity that can survive. You don't know where you are coming from, you won't know where you are going, and your future is not certain. China, Japan, some of these Asian countries, they don't relegate their history, their culture, their art to the, in fact, the intangible heritage, you know, of any nation, you know, goes a long way to ensure, you know, what I mean by intangible heritage is that oral tradition, you know, poetry, you know, our way of greeting, our way of relationship with people, honesty. These are what are embedded in, you know, in the, for example, Yoruba beliefs and value system. If people don't reckon with it, people don't, we will be doing our own, and we are still doing it. We celebrate what Oshobo people say they value. We promote and we help to preserve both the physical and the tangible heritage, you know, of the people.
Museum and monument. We used to come here every year to come and invite our students for a yearly program concerning the groove. Pick out of the students to the groove. We explain everything to them. And after this, they will ask some questions or to ascertain what they have assimilated. We have some people from overseas countries outside this state. They used to come here. When those people can come here, what about the people in the area? They must know something about their culture. They must know something about it. So it helps the students.
If we are talking of cultural aspects, there is nothing against the culture. The culture is in line with what Almighty Allah wants. But if the culture against the area of belief in each religion, it won't be accepted. We use our religion as a measure to
Culture is different from religion. When we are promoting culture, it not necessarily means that we don't believe. Both Christians and Muslims, most especially the young ones, all of us, we do embrace the culture. Those people that particularly have that Osunsogbo as their God, they are the Yaosun, they are Rubas, they are Woros. Go to the group, we see them. If there is any problem or somebody is in a certain problem, if you go there, after going there, they will ask them to bring ram, to bring snail, to bring whatever. They will collect it and do whatever they want to do for that person. For those who are the problem. Those are the people that are worshipping Osunsogbo. But in our own case, we are promoting the culture of Osunsogbo.
Any problem, Lafika? Igba wa idoti la ma pe musa si ti asinu ani musa si mi ju be yen lo ton ton baba je so gbe ti je ti mama si ni bosun ko se ko ti o ba si mama ibe o le assist mo mo so wa fun yin.
What traditional African religions represent really is spirituality. You know, and as long as people don't use certain elements of that to wish people evil, you know, people claim that there is a capacity in certain types of religion to do that, it is perfectly okay. I have no problems with African religion. In fact, I think we should study it more and see the extent to which more and more people will understand the various aspects of its spiritual dimension, and through that, rediscover their Africanness. Because at its stand right now, there are a lot of people abdicating from our traditions because established or organized religion is telling us that our tradition is pagan. And I don't subscribe to that.
Well, Odu Milati, we in Timofe, we are Yoruba. Because we are in the Yandudu, at the Bagoris, we are. I want to reason, reason, okay. Reason, reason, and live. Reason, what it by way. Want to be what it by way. Yawa, at by way. Babimba, Balang party woe. Yella, young party woe. This was his say, and I was. He said, what's it? Ogina gang. Mohammedi, kissing Arabian, anyone. More batiabon. I'm batting one day. Uncle Wawa, Uncle Politics, you are. One in Kataka, Bakaba, Jasawa, Kabaje. At it by way as hello me. Kun da ko baba re mo Jesus mo Jesus Muhammad o baba to bi onko ati gbagbe won orisun orisun la leki nkan won foroju tu sa lo lo ni sa ni nkan oro ni sa lagbara ni sa ni gbogbe ni ama ti gbagbe orisun wa e ti wa gbagbe orisun yo gbe ni lo fa arin
tori ta ba ri pa won kan fe se ere nsin tan wa ba wa tan ba ni nipa ohun ma lo osun a man so fun won pe gbogbo en to ba ti fe lo osun o ko nse pe ka e debe ka e lo ma so yi pe osun bayi lo seri osun bayi lo seri o nkan to ba je ko ma gbe osun soke ohun la wa fe gbogbo nkan to ba ti le gbe osun sile e gbodo se ta ba fi le mo a ni gba fun yin o so ara iru ipa ta n ko niyan lati ma je ki asa wa ko parun ati esi ti ta wa tori a ni fe ko ba je
Granted that most indigenes of Oshogbo do not fraternize with the grove, during the Osun Oshogbo festival, many people living in the town benefit economically from the festival. The festival period has become an economic opportunity in Oshogbo.
During the celebration of the festival, and because of what Susawenja has done to expose our culture, the economy situation of the country used to improve. They are usually be buying and selling within the town, within that period. The economic situation of the people in Oshogbo will improve gradually. The petty traders, the hoteliers, they used to be very happy. They usually wait patiently when Oshogbo will come, where their turnover will be increased. So economically, Susawenja has improved our culture.
A lot of tourists, they come to Oshogbo because of the groove. Even now, not during the festival, a lot of tourists that do troop in from all parts of the globe to visit Oshogbo, to the name they had in art. They believe Oshogbo is a mecca of artists. And during the festival, I can say during the festival, those that benefit most, they are the hoteliers, food sellers. You know, tourists don't buy artwork so much. They buy souvenirs. They buy small things.
Anybody don't know why I went yalala. Kabiyesi, Oloyeli, Gomina, Latabuda. Anybody will go on your wabi.
During the Osun Oshogbo festival, people are many here to watch the festival. And we still have a lot of tourists that are here for the festival. They book all the hotels in Oshogbo. And all the artists, they organize some art exhibition for them during the festival, and they make their money.
500!
Nipa odun osun ojo yen mi saba mo ma saba sise gan ni gboro tori asebun machine engineering ni mi sugba ni jo yen mo ma fi se yen le ti ma lo si iboro pelu okada tori awon eyan eyan ma wa lati Eko a ma wa lati abroad to je pe tan ba de elomi gugu obi ti o ba mo a ni lati ma gbe kaakiri lo be to je pe ta ba gbe lo be tan a ma n ri owo gidi gba ni owo won
won le boto ki won pada mo sa si won won le lo mo lo church won sugba wa ta wa lenu re ri ta wo ko nbe gba kan
nipa ti ele iteni yen so emi o ko salamo lati oni to won yi won so pa won o wa won o wa sugbon ta ba nse odun osun ari to e pe ati gbe ese gan asoro ti gbogbo e ma di bero se ma npo to won wa lati dikibi ai mo yi omo osogbo na to da je pe tori osun lo ma n wale elomi lati ilu oyinbo lo ti ma wale lati wa wo osun so to ba so be o le so loju o bo inuji ai mo ye elomi ka kukun ri to ye pe adijo ma se kini bayi o de ma de ibi to ti ma de ani olorun ma e ko nlo so opolopo won po gbogbo bi to de n fara pamo si na le gbogbo eyan mo kabo.
Another thing I've been able to find out is that in the grove here, I think the grove is not solely meant for tourist purpose.
No.
Because I've been told that there are several spots where ordinary people can't get to in the grove. But
no, it's not like that. It is only Ifa Grove and Ogoni, but which Ogboni House, which is the second palace. We don't take people there because it's meant for, they are using, the Ogboni people are using it for their meeting place. So we don't take people there. And there's another one, we call it Tiba Grove. We don't go inside that grove.
So a place is meant for tourists, I think tourists must have the opportunity to visit every spot. There shouldn't be exemption.
But the site is a sacred forest.
Okay.
It's a sacred forest. So we still have some traditionalists that are coming here for maybe they were here to pray or to meditate.
As I went in and out of Oshogbo, some questions kept knocking on the door of my heart. Have Christianity and Islam truly robbed us of our cultural heritage? To what extent will our cultural heritage survive without our indigenous religions? How can the Oshogbo patrimony live on without our traditional religion? As I journeyed back home, I thought about the warning given by my Christian brethren. Well, I came in contact with no demon as I walked the whole length and breadth of the grove, except the few sacred areas I dared not visit. But I think it's time we kept and protected our cultural heritage. If we do not, then things are bound to fall apart. When things fall apart, anarchy becomes loosed upon our society.
Bye.